In this video, I am going to show how to do the Odoo ERP backup. For that, we need to open the browser and enter the URL of Odoo application. Then click the Manage Database. Now you can see the option of Backup, Duplicate, Delete. Here I am going to show how to do the backup. If you press backup button, it will ask for a backup. If you click the duplicate button, it will ask the new database name. And if you want to delete, we can delete like that. For these all operation, we require master password. This is the password we are entering while creating the Odoo database. This will be common for all database. We have already created testnet123. That is a backup password we are using. Here I am going to show how to do the backup. Once after entering the master password, there is an option, backup format. Here you can see two options. One is zip format, including file store. Another one is dump file. The file store contains full backup of the system, including the attachment. But in the case of dump file, it will contain only the database file. It will not contain any attachment. So we need to take both backup. We are preferring always with the file store. First, I am taking zip backup. That means including file store. Once after selecting the format, we can press backup. It will start the backup button. It will start the backup. We can see on the download folder. Same way, we can take the backup of dump file. Just select the dump file and click the backup. That will also show in download folder. Next, we are going to look how to do the duplicate database. Duplicate means it will duplicate the existing database. That means you will get two databases. If you have two company, you can simply create two databases. Put any name for the new database. Then enter the master password. And press continue. Now you can see two database. The two database indicating two different data. If you are logging, you need to make sure you are selecting the right database for entering the data. Now I am going to show how to restore the database. Go to the restore database button. Choose the database file which we have backup. Open that file. And enter the master password. And put the database name. In the bottom you can see this database is a copy. This database was moved. That is a two option. If we are restoring on the same system with a different name, we need to use database as a copy. If we are restoring with the same name, we need to use this database was moved. Otherwise, it will make conflict. So make sure before doing this. Here I am selecting this database is a copy. Pressing continue. Now you can see the database is restored with a new name. If you want to delete any database, select the corresponding delete button and enter the master password. Then press the delete button. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, please press the like button, comment and subscribe.